everyone. My name is Emily Summers, and this is the Emily Summers Show. Today, we are talking about bullying. 13 million kids will be bullied in the U.S. this year. 3 million kids will be absent from school every single month because they don't feel safe at school. This is a problem that is affecting so many of the kids in our community, and it's time for us to do something about it. Whether you're a student, a teacher, an administrator, a parent, a grandparent, or even just a member of our community, it's time to take bullying seriously. Let's take a stand and make schools and our community a place where every single kid feels safe, accepted, and most importantly, happy. We have two guests on the show today. They both have been bullied, but they are now fighting to make a difference. Our first guest is Brady Holiday. He is an eighth grader at West Middle School. Here's his story.
After spending much of his time at West Middle School a target of bullying, Brady Holiday, an eighth grader, decided it was time to stand up for himself and for others who are being bullied.
There's a lot that I could talk about, but one that really set me over the edge was when a kid kept telling me to call him a name so he could do something to me, and I told him I didn't want to, but he called me names, and it made me leave the classroom because I didn't want everyone to see me crying. So I walked out, and that was the end. And later in the hallway, he told me if he saw me telling someone about him bullying me, that he and his friends would kill me.
Brady had thoughts of retaliating, but instead he decided to not let the bullies bring him down.
I always thought about retaliating, but I wondered how much it would hurt them. Like, it hurt me because they hurt me, but I didn't want to do the same and hurt someone else because I knew how it felt.
Julie Holiday, Brady's mother and a single mother of four, explained to us how bad the bullying got.
Brady was used to love going to school. He didn't like summer vacation. He could not wait for summer to be back, you know, be over and get back in school. And then in seventh grade, he started calling me like every day, wanting to come home. And he started telling me in the mornings that he didn't feel good and he didn't want to go to school. And so it just went on from there, and I knew something was wrong, but he wouldn't ever tell me what exactly was going on, and then he finally did.
Brady decided it was time to be a part of fixing this problem. Brady came up with an idea of starting a club called It Only Gets Better.
It was one day that I started thinking in my head, this is my life, so I shouldn't let everyone be able to change it. I had an idea of starting one, so I started, and then I took off with the idea. I came up with the name because I was bullied every day, and it got better, and it can get better for everyone else too.
The club is a place where kids can get together, share their stories, and come up with solutions to help end bullying.
I wanted to be part of it because I see a lot of bullying at the school I go to, which is West, and I also wanted to help support my friends.
I've seen other people bullied, so I kind of want to stop it.
No, it's a prevalent problem in our community, and I definitely think it needs to be addressed, and this is a good way to do it.
Brady had one last message that he wishes every single bully would understand.
They don't understand how much their words can hurt someone.
Every Sunday at Musser Public Library, the club meets. Everyone in the community is invited to support Brady and help end bullying in Muscatine.
Thanks for being here today, Brady. Brady, are you still being bullied?
Yes. 2 days ago, a kid told me I have to go buy a bra, and he called me gay. And two other students continue to bully me, and it's been going on for a long time, but I'm trying my best to ignore it. And I think that they're doing it because I'm putting myself out there, so.
Right. And you're putting yourself out there by starting your own club, right, to help end bullying, which I think that's so awesome because you're only in eighth grade and you are smart enough and strong enough of a person to start something from such a negative situation with you getting bullied. And you turned it into something so positive. What are your goals for the club?
I want it to be big, and not only, I'm not doing this for the fame and fortune. I'm doing this because I know that there's someone, I can make a difference in someone's life.
Right, and that, of course, you're not doing it for the fame, right? You're doing it because you want to make a difference. And that's awesome, too, that now that you know how it feels to be bullied, now you're using that to want to help other people so they don't have to go through that. Is that kind of the reason you started the club?
Yeah, that's mostly
that fun. Is. And do you have any goals or future hopes for the club? Like any projects you're working on with it?
Well, we're trying to build a float so we can be in the 4th of July parade and maybe set up a booth down in the on the riverfront so when people are watching the fireworks they can come check it out. We can hand them a brochure.
Very cool. That's a good idea. So you started being bullied last year when you were a 7th grader, correct?
Yes.
Yes. And has the bullying gotten any better or is it just as bad?
Well, last year was really horrible mm-hmm. and most days I couldn't go a full day of school.
Really?
And I probably missed over 30 days. But this year I had a brand new start and I knew I wasn't going to let this happen again because I went through a whole year with it and starting a new school year is like starting a whole new life.
That's
basically.
True, yeah. That's so it is a little bit better than last year though?
Yeah, it's not as bad as it was last year because now I know that they're doing this because I'm putting myself out there.
And they're trying to bring you down and make you not think that you can go and make a difference. After you went home from school, were you able to forget about the bullying or what was the effect that it had on you at home?
Well, my mom said this and it almost made me cry. She said I was a completely different person at school and I was always quiet and I didn't want to be around people, but when I was home, I would laugh and I would love to be around my family. But usually when there were big incidents, I wouldn't forget about it. But if there were little names or whatever, I could forget about it because I was used to it.
Right. And you, for a long time, didn't tell your mom that the bullying was happening. Why didn't you tell her?
Well, I was afraid that if I told someone, it would... the adult would try to do something or talk to the kids mm-hmm. and it would just make it worse. And one of my situations, an adult talked to the kid and he had threatened me in the hallway later and told me if I told anyone that he had talked to me again in the hallway, him and his friends would kill my fat.
Oh man.
Yeah.
So they threatened you. And did you go at all to the principal when that happened?
No. But later on, I realized it's helpful to let your anger out mm-hmm. or tell an adult because holding it in, it's not going to release crying or sadness. It's going to be anger.
And you're going to bottle it all up inside of you and then probably
it'll just explode.
Exactly, yep. Do you wish you would have told your mom sooner or told a trusted adult?
I think if I told my mom sooner, it probably wouldn't be this bad.
You do.
But I probably wouldn't be here right now because it would have been stopped earlier.
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, I'm not happy that it kept going, but I'm now that it happened, I'm okay with it because it led me here and it made me a stronger person.
And that is so true. And that just amazes me that you already know that even though it's still happening right now, and the bullying is still happening, that it's making you a stronger person. Is that one of your passions, helping others? And
yes.
Do you think you've developed that because you've been bullied?
I think so. And I had a counselor that would come down from Davenport.
Mm-hmm.
His name is James Crawford. And he has helped me this whole way. And when I was in the play, my last night on Saturday, he was there in the audience and he got to hear me sing and perform. And afterwards, my mom was thanking him and saying that if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be here. And if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be here.
Aww.
But he says he steered the car.
Mm-hmm.
I steered the car, but he would, you know, tell me some of the
kind
directions.
Kind of the right directions to go. What was the biggest thing that he taught you?
I have to be myself. I have to be okay with being Brady mm-hmm. in front of one person or millions of people.
And are you?
Yes.
You are. That's something so important because if you are okay with the person that you are and the person that you are meant to be, then you'll be more confident, right? And you won't let people bring you down. It can help with stopping the bullying? Like you said earlier, if you would have told your mom sooner, you don't think the bullying would have gotten as bad. And do you have any messages for the bullies? Like, let's say one of the kid who is bullying you right now was sitting here. What would you tell them?
I would ask him why he's doing this. And most of the kids that do this, that bully others, do it because they have been bullied before. Mm-hmm. And I would ask them, why are you doing this? I know you know how it feels, but you do know how it feels. So why would you bully others because you know how it feels and it hurts? And a lot of the people that bullied me last year have apologized to me.
They have. That is awesome. They knew how much it hurt, so they apologized. Have you ever had anybody stick up for you when you were being bullied? You did.
Andrea, who's sitting over there, mm-hmm. and my two best friends, Kieran and Patrick Burns. About 2 weeks ago, Patrick said to me, he wanted to start this comedy web show, and me and my friends were on board with it. And my math teacher, Mr. Nitzel, gave a presentation about anti-bullying because a kid had committed suicide because he was openly gay. And it really made a lot of people upset. And then afterwards, a lot of people started talking to me and being nice to me that they hadn't before.
Wow.
But that same day, my friend Patrick, he said to me, because I told him, I'm not sure if I can do this web show because I really want to do something about these bullies. Mm-hmm. And he told me, Brady, you can't stop, no offense or anything, but you can't stop bullying. And I said, a lot of people told me that last year, and I actually started to believe him, but I had to realize that, I mean, I can do whatever I want.
You can,
and
sure.
I can be whatever I want. And I'm not going to let someone stop me because I know I can make a difference.
There's a lot of non-believers in this world, Brady, just so you know. There's a lot of people who believe that one person can't make a difference and one person can't help end bullying a little bit, you know? I mean, you might not take care of all the problem with it, but you can make a huge difference with it.
Actually, before I came here, I was in one of my grandma's rooms in her house, and I saw this book that my cousin Deegan has been working on, and it's from your preschool year all the way to your graduation, and each year you fill out what's happening in your life, and at the very end it said, life isn't a destination, it's a journey, and it really impacted me, and I thought that was a really good quote, because life isn't a destination, it's a journey, and you have to enjoy the journey, because
exactly.
You never know when it could end.
You're right, and even if there are people out there who are trying to bring you down, you can't let them, and it's your life, so you have to do what makes you happy, and you have to do the things that you love, and it is a journey. There's sometimes that you get hurt, but that's all part of the person you're meant to be, right? Well, thank you so much for being here today and sharing your story. If you want to be involved in the club, it only gets better. The club meets every Sunday at Musser Public Library at 1 o'clock. Everyone in the community is invited. If you are being bullied like Brady is, just try and focus on the positive things in your life. Also, work on loving who you are and be okay with the person that you were made to be. Just remember that no one can bring you down unless you let them. Make sure to reach out to teachers and administrators and keep telling until someone makes the bullying stop. And if that doesn't stop the bullying, email me at emilysummershow@gmail.com, and I'll do everything in my power to help. Our next guest is Maggie Gelson. Maggie is a junior at Central High School in DeWitt. Here's Maggie's story.
Maggie Gelson began getting bullied when she was in fourth grade. She attended St. Joe's in DeWitt, Iowa.
There was never an incident that really started the bullying that happened.
Maggie started receiving hate mail on MSN Messenger. The messages included a lot of vulgar language. Maggie reached out to her teacher, and the girls were forced to apologize. However, the bullying didn't stop. Maggie was in seventh grade. She was crowned Junior Miss Clinton County. She had the opportunity to twirl at Magic Kingdom.
When I returned from Disney World, I remember we had to write a research paper, or it was just a human interest type thing, and I wrote mine on the performance I did at Disney World. And when we did peer revisions, I remember there were some nasty comments written at the top of my paper from some girls in my class, and it was just a lot of cattiness that went on.
Throughout middle school was the worst years of her life because she was bullied. She got to a point where she wanted to move, switch schools. She had thoughts of self-inflicted injury. And at one point, she didn't even want to be on this earth anymore.
I asked my parents multiple times if we could move and if I could switch schools. And at one point, I just really didn't want to be on earth. And I really, those aren't normal thoughts for a fourth through eighth grader or even anybody to have. So that's when we knew that it was really getting bad.
When she began high school, she was never bullied again. Maggie is now a junior in high school. She was crowned Miss Muscatine's Outstanding Teen this January, and she gets to compete in Miss Iowa's Outstanding Teen this June. She is very passionate about volunteering and making a difference.
So if we're able to be healthy, that means we can give back to our communities. You love the community you live in, right?
Yeah.
You love the town you live in, you love the people who are here?
Yeah.
Right. So how are we going to give back to our communities? By volunteering. And in order to volunteer, we need to stay healthy, don't we? Awesome.
She loves being a positive role model for young kids. She makes many appearances performing her talent. And offering good advice for kids about healthy eating and exercise habits. Maggie now looks back at those years of being bullied as a growing experience. It made her much stronger as an individual, and it taught her to accept everyone, no matter how different they are.
With us, we have Miss Muscatine, Maggie Gelson. Maggie, thanks for being here today.
Thank you.
So you started being bullied on MSN Messenger, correct?
Yes.
And do you think that the bullying was, like, it was worse on there or at school?
I would say probably on the Messenger and on email and stuff like that, just because kids are, they feel more comfortable saying things via a message rather
right.
than to your face. So a lot of the messages I did receive were very vulgar and just very hurtful, for especially for being in fourth grade.
Yeah.
That was very disappointing for me and something that really stuck with me for a while.
I bet. I think the reason that it is so much easier for kids who are on their other side on the computer mm-hmm. saying mean things because they don't have to see your reaction
exactly.
and see how it made you feel or see your face. Mm-hmm. What would have those girls who were saying mean things to you, what would have they seen if they did?
They would have gotten exactly what they wanted, actually.
Mm-hmm.
I was very, very upset for a long time. And the bullying really the bullies were very persistent. They kept going, and I was bullied pretty much until my eighth grade year. And that was finally when it started getting a little better and and finally stopped, actually.
Not only did you have kids who bullied you, you said that you had a teacher
yes.
who bullied you verbally and mentally. Can you talk about that?
Well, I had an incident with this teacher where I just felt very, very kind of centered by this teacher, kind of cornered almost. And I remember she took me out of class one day and ended up accusing me of something that I had not done, and it pertained to something with her class, and pretty much accused me of cheating. And I really felt hurt by that because I knew that I had done the work and I had
mm-hmm.
really done my best, and it wasn't a subject I was strong in either. So that really made me mentally really just, I felt awful mentally because I felt like she was criticizing what my mental capabilities were.
Right.
So I felt like my schoolwork really went downhill from there too, and that was all in sixth grade.
Oh. And then in fourth grade, mm-hmm. when the bullying began, you actually printed off the messages
yes.
mm-hmm. and you took them to your teacher.
Mm-hmm.
And the bullies were forced to apologize, but it didn't stop the bullying, correct?
Yes.
It kept yep. going on. What do you think that you could have done more to help stop the bullying?
I think if I had just really focused a lot on trying to make the bullying stop,
mm-hmm.
I could have done something like what Brady's doing. I could have started a club, or I could have taken this to administration for the entire district
right.
or something along those lines. And I really do now wish that I had done more. And I'm glad to see that there are
bullying programs being established in schools. I think that's great.
Yeah, I agree. We're in sixth grade. The bullying got very bad, and you actually had thoughts about not wanting to be on the earth anymore. What do you think drove those thoughts?
I really just think it was the things that people were saying to me. And when I say saying, I don't mean to my face. They said it to me all through instant messaging, and cyberbullying was really the culprit of making me feel like that and making me have thoughts of suicide when I was so young. And that's not okay. That's not normal for a sixth grader, or for anybody for that matter, to have thoughts of suicide after having something said to them. So I really was just hurt by a lot of the messages I received, and it didn't even have to be to my face.
Right.
A lot of times it was what they weren't saying. They would ignore me, and they would, you know, not talk to me at school and not invite me to sit with them or something like that, and that really hurt me a lot.
I think that can be actually sometimes worse, mm-hmm. of just ignoring you. One girl one time told me that she was new to the school, and she said that it is actually better if she would actually like people to be making fun of her, because then they'd actually give her attention.
Right.
Because they just acted like she wasn't even there. Mm-hmm. Which that is a form of bullying. I don't think a lot of people realize that.
Yeah, a lot of times it is what they don't say.
Mm-hmm.
And it is that they just kind of shun you away for no reason. And that really, it makes kids wonder. It makes them wonder what they did when they didn't do anything.
Exactly,
at all.
And like, what's wrong with me?
Exactly.
Because they don't want to hang out with me or invite me over.
Definitely.
And I think that people don't really realize how powerful it can be to just sit with someone at lunch or invite them to be your partner in school.
Absolutely.
What do you think that would have done for you if somebody would have done that?
If somebody had just maybe asked me to sit with them at lunch, like you said, that would have changed my whole outlook on things. That would have really made me realize that there are people who care, and there are people who are going to be inviting. And the fact that no one did that, I mean, I think there were two, and those were my two best friends all through middle school. But other than that, there was just that whole group of popular girls never talked to me and never made an effort to be friends with me. And that really hurt me. That really made me feel, you know, that made me feel inferior. That made me feel like I had no control over the situation.
Right. I can imagine that it would, because you have all of those girls just leaving you out.
Exactly.
And I just wish people would realize that, you know, that just be people's friends, accept everyone, and just be friends with everyone. And you are just here to show that how that would have impacted your life so much if somebody just sat with you at lunch.
Exactly. Like you were saying, it's just, it makes such an impact. And I remember this one time, there was another girl who was having the same troubles as I was. She wasn't really necessarily being bullied by the things that people were saying, but like I said, what they weren't saying to her. And so I remember one day she came and sat by me at lunch, and that really made me feel awesome. That just made me feel like, you know, somebody cared and somebody really wanted to be there for me.
Right. So now you have so much going for you. I mean, you're Miss Muscatine right now. You've done really well. You were in Miss Iowa the last 2 years,
yes,
for Outstanding Teen, and did top five both years.
Yes.
And now you get to go compete in June.
Yes.
Are you super excited for that?
I can't even put into words how excited I am for it. I've worked really, really hard for this, and it's something I've wanted for a really long time, and knowing that I get another chance at it is the best feeling in the world.
Right, and I think you got it.
Well, thank you.
Because you're working so hard, and you're really trying to make a difference.
Thank you.
And with your platform, it's about eating healthy. What is your platform?
My platform is called Fit for Life, A Choice Made Early, and it addresses childhood obesity.
Very good. And that's something very important, too, to teach kids to be healthy and exercise.
Mm-hmm.
How happy are you that you did stick out the bullying and you kept fighting and you didn't give up?
I cannot even express how thrilled I am that I stuck through that and got through everything, because once I got to high school, my world was changed. I mean, I am friends with people from almost every different clique now. I have a lot of really diverse friends, and that for me, that's awesome, and that's what it's all about.
Right.
And for me, also, when I got to high school, I became friends with a lot of the public school kids, and they were all so welcoming and inviting to me when I got there that I just felt like so many people cared about me, and that I really did have friends who were true friends to me. Mm-hmm. So it felt great once I finally moved past that, and then I accomplished a lot of my goals once I finally moved past all the bullying and just didn't let them get to me. And I wouldn't have accomplished those goals had I let them really get what they wanted and
You're
really
right.
get to me.
Yep. Was your confidence really low during the bullying?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I really didn't think highly of myself at all, and I really didn't think highly of myself actually until last year. I really had a lot of trouble with gaining confidence throughout middle school and even the first couple of years of high school. And now I just feel great about myself. I am really loving what I'm doing. I'm really liking the place that I'm at right now in my life. So,
how did you gain that confidence? Because I'm sure your confidence was beat down from the bullies. Mm-hmm. How did you get up to there where you're now confident and you love yourself?
My parents and my family helped a lot. And the two best friends that I had through middle school really helped me. And then, like I said, once I got to high school, my confidence just really grew from there once I started having those friends who were had my back and who were really supporting me in everything I did. So once I just kind of really got over the fact that the bullying didn't matter anymore, that what they were saying didn't matter, that is when I really gained my confidence and really learned to love myself after that.
Right, and you just have to remember that, right? That absolutely. The bullies are trying to say things to bring you down, but you have to be in control and you have to say, I'm not gonna let this hurt me.
That's their goal, that's all they want from you. They just want to see you upset and they want to see you cry, they want to see you be mad. That's all they want from you is a reaction. Mm-hmm. And my mom always told me that. Every day that I didn't want to go to school because there were bullies, and every day that I would come home and be really upset, she said, this is what they want from you. This upset Maggie is what they want. Mm-hmm. They want you to be really mad, and they want you to be sad, and they want you to really hate life, and I wasn't going to let them get away with it.
Right, and that's awesome that you didn't, because now you have so much to look forward to in your life.
Yes, I'm very excited.
What message do you have for anyone who is being bullied right now?
Take action. Brady is doing an awesome, awesome thing. Starting that anti-bullying club is a wonderful thing, and I'm sure that he's helping so many kids in his school. And now there are a lot more bullying rules being enforced in schools, and that's wonderful. That's something that we needed. And if you're having trouble with bullies in your school, or really just, are feeling beat down by one particular person or a teacher or somebody, then go to someone. Don't keep it bottled up. You need to talk to a friend, a parent, a teacher, an administrator, anybody. Anybody is somebody. So at least you're talking to someone about it.
What can parents do if their kid is being bullied?
My mom did the best thing that she could, and she went right to the school. She went right to my principal and she discussed it with her. And that is the best thing a parent can do. Mm-hmm. And provide support, just be there. Be there for your child, and I mean, which I'm sure any parent does anyway, but really tell them what my mom told me. Don't let them get to you, and that's all they want from you is a reaction. Mm-hmm. That is the best advice that she ever gave me, and that's the best thing I've ever heard from somebody.
I think that's true. Just don't let them bring you down.
Absolutely.
Because you're going to get so much farther in life if you don't. Well, thank you so much for being here,
thank
and
you.
I wish you the best of luck in Miss Iowa's outstanding team.
Thank you very much.
The Dear Edwina cast at West Middle School helped to make the next video. They sang this song called Sing Your Own Song from the musical. In the song, many kids share their experiences with being bullied and share some advice. Here's the video.
Those kids that try to knock you down, they're not what life's about. Just learn to sing your special song and drown them out.
I've been bullied in most of the schools I went to.
They made fun of us because we messed up.
You have to sing your own song, use your own voice.
Somebody told me that nobody liked me. I figured out that I have a lot of people that like me.
I felt very insecure when he was bullying me.
I used to go to an old school and I was bullied at that school. She would try to punch me and kick me. She tricked my friends into hating me.
No more poems in your heart. Do you really want to live your life that way?
When my dad passed away, everyone thought that I was just like wanting my dad to die because I liked the attention.
To make their talents fly. It's hard to let you so much joy can make you cry.
I wanted to go to online school because people were picking on me.
I had been bullied starting my seventh grade year I've been bullied on Facebook and learned that a lot of people like to use cyberbully because they don't like to do it to other people's faces. I have been bullied by a girl that goes here, and she had actually told me to go kill myself because I was worthless.
I was bullied when I was getting ready for the play Dear Edwina for West Middle School. Don't let them take away the music that you made of. I was really upset and I was scared to perform in front of them, but I performed, I did my best, and after I got a lot of compliments and after all those boys had something good to say.
You just gotta think you're your own person, and no matter what they say and no matter what they do, you will always be you.
Bullying does go on in my school, and when I see bullying, and I would just want to tell the person that they need to be confident in who they are.
Made me think maybe I should pray for them because maybe they have something going on at home.
If that kind of thing happens to you, just remember that there are people that still love you.
We will stand up to bullying!
One quote that I live by is, you're part of the problem until you stand up and do something about it. So let's all stand up and stop bullying. If you're a student, make sure to include everyone. And if you see bullying, tell the bully to stop. You never know how powerful that word could be to the kid who is being bullied. It could even change their life. If you're a teacher or an administrator, make sure to take bullying seriously and do everything in your power to make the bullying stop. We need to help kids feel safe at school. And if you're a parent of a kid who is being bullied, keep telling teachers or the principal or even go to the superintendent until the bullying stops. Also, teach your kid to be confident with who they are and to love themselves. If kids and adults take a stand and don't allow bullying to happen, then it won't. I'm always looking for new ideas for my show. So if you or anyone you know has a story to share that will make a difference, please email me at emilysummershow@gmail.com.